Hello everyone. In our last video, we were discussing about the derivatives of the skin. So in this video, we are going to continue with that chapter. In this video, we will discuss about the skin and the heat regulation of the body as well as the other things. So there are the two other topics also we will discuss in this video. Let us begin. First one, the skin and the heat regulation of the body. You know that the human beings are the warm-blooded organisms. Warm-blooded means these are also known as endothermal. Why endothermal? Because heat is produced in their body from inside. Okay, that's why they are able to survive in the cold weather as well as in the warm weather too. So that's why they are known as the warm-blooded organisms. As well as if you talk about the animals, animals are the cold-blooded organisms, and whenever the winters start, some organisms, some animals hibernate in that weather. Why they are hibernating in that weather? Because their body is not able to survive in the cold weather. They are not able to change their body temperature according to the temperature of the weather. That's why they hibernate or go into the sleep, winter sleep. And by that way, they are showing the hibernation process. So the human organisms are known as the human beings, and the other animals too are known as, few animals are known as the warm-blooded organisms. Human body temperature is usually 37 degrees Celsius, means that is normal 98 degrees Celsius. It is about the 1 degree higher in the rectum and about the 1 degree lower in the armpits. So it is usually 37 degrees Celsius. If we talk about the fan heat, then that is different. Our body temperature may also show variation from the 0.3 degrees Celsius to 0.5 degrees Celsius in course of 24 hours. It is the lowest in the early morning and highest in the late afternoon time, and optimum temperature is 35 degrees to 40 degrees Celsius for the normal body activities also, because in our body there is a production of the enzymes and the secretion of the enzyme too. So few enzymes that are secreting in our body are not able to secrete on the higher temperature. So for the suitability of our body temperature, the moderate temperature of our body is 35 degree to 40 degrees Celsius. Next one, heat production. Heat production means chemical reactions occur in our body cells, and due to the production of that chemical cells, due to the working of that chemical cells, our body is producing the heat, and that heat is coming, our blood is also able to regulate that heat, as well as whenever we are drinking water, that water is also regulating our body temperature, and sweat is coming out with the expulsion of the sweat also. It is responsible to regulate our body heat at the body temperature. Heat loss. Now heat lost is from our body through the following four channels. First is known as the skin, second one lungs, third is urine or feces, and the fourth one is food. Skin, 85% of our body heat is lost by the skin. As I gave you the example, 2 to 3 times that with the help of skin sweat is coming out, and with the help of sweat the heat is lost from our skin part, from our body part, as well as the conduction radiation through the evaporation of the skin whole occur in by the sweat only. By the skin. Lungs, heat is lost in the warm air which is breathed out. Now with the breathe out air, the heat is lost by the lungs. By that way, the heat is coming out from the skin. Next is urine or even the feces. Discharge, the substances are eliminated at the body temperature. So by that way also heat is lost from our body. Foods, heat is also lost when cold food, water or cold beverages are taken into the body. Beverages means whenever we are taking the cold drinks as well as tea, coffee, and the other liquid contents are known as beverages. Tea, coffee, cold drinks, okay, that are. Next, temperature regulation. The principle of heat regulation center is located in the hypothalamus. Now, who is responsible to regulate the heat of our body? Hypothalamus. Keep in mind, this is very important. So, hypothalamus is regulating and our heat of the body. A portion of the forebrain, where the hypothalamus is present in the forebrain of the body. This part acts as like a thermostat. Thermostat, when the body tends to cool below the normal temperature, it switches on and speeds up the heat production processes. And when body tends to overheated, it accelerates the cooling process and switch off the heat production processes. So hypothalamus is totally controlling our body temperature. Whenever the heat is more in our body, then definitely it works for to cool down our body. Afterward, whenever our body is cool, then it works or giving the heat to our body for the normal conditions or for the normal of our body. Next one, in the cold weathers. In the cold weather, what is happening outside? The temperature is very lesser as compared to our body. The blood vessels get narrower in that sense because outside the temperature is more. Now in that sense, our blood vessels becomes narrower, and this is known as vasocontractions. Contraction, vasocontraction, why it happens? Because outside the weather is cold now, and our body need to keep our body temperature in a moderate state so that our body is able to do its work properly. So in that sense, what is happening? Our vessels automatically becomes narrowed, and they are not allowing any loss of heat from the skin, and by that way our body temperature becomes normal, and our body is able to respond properly, and we are able to work properly. Sometimes you may experience that whenever you are going to the hair stations in the winters, or if there is a snow, then what is happening? Some persons are getting the breathing problem also. Why it is happening? Because their body is not able to get the heat, proper heat, and in that sense their arteries blocked and they are not able to breathe properly, and they are facing the problems. So in that sense, what is happening? Vasocontraction. Our body shows vasocontraction. The vessels becomes narrowed due to the prevention of the heat loss. Next one, in the hot weathers. In the hot weather, what is happening? Because outside now the temperature is high and our body don't need this much high temperature, then what is happening? Automatically the overproduction of heat in our body takes place, and supply to the skin is increased by the dilation of the blood vessel in the skin, and this is known as the vasodilation. Vasodilation occur because outside now temperature is more, and our body has to keep our body on the normal temperature. So our body, our vessel shows dilation mode, and in the dilation mode, that is known as vasodilation, and the arteries are showing the more blood supply to our other parts of the body. By that way, the more heat lost is there, you are getting more sweat. That means that heat is coming out from your body and your body remain on the normal state. So that is known as a vasodilation, and the other one is known as a vasoconstriction. So hope you understood about that. Next one is the heat stroke. Sometimes you may have seen or you may have observed that due to the high weather, whenever the temperature raises, means during the summers, what is happening? Some persons become unconscious, as well as they are getting the rashes on their skin, sunstrokes they are getting. Why they are getting? Because their body temperature is more in that state, and their vasodilation is not proper in their body, and they are getting sunstrokes as well as the patches, red patches on the skin. So that is happening due to that. So in that sense, some persons are using sunscreen and the other products to keep their body safe from the sunlight and to keep their body at the normal temperature. So this was all about the skin topic, the chapter of the skin we have discussed. Hope you understood about that. Thank you very much.